why not? I want the umbrella hat.
I'm gonna run across it. Gentlemen, welcome to the Barbican Football Field for today's main event as the young Jamaica Reggae Warriors face off against the young Canada Wolverines in a historic international test match. It's the first time both nations are fielding a team at this age level. And of course, it's going to be a really exciting game today. We're of course happy to have the Canadians here. They have traveled a long way, staying out in Otrius. They played in a nine-a-side competition on Wednesday against local high schools. They were victorious in that competition, squeezing past the Spanish Town High School 12-8 in that finals on Wednesday. Of course, the makeup of Jamaica's national under-17 team today will see players from various high schools playing rugby league in Jamaica. We have players from Spanish Town High, St. Catherine High, Bogwalk High, Aracabessa High, Calabar High, and St. George's College. Both squads today will feature 22 players. Changes will be unlimited. And of course, it's 8 minutes of hard-hitting action between the young and international players of both teams. A round of applause as we see the Canadians taking the field. Welcome, welcome, welcome to John Ross. Happy to have you here, boys. Big up, of course, the management team of Canada who put this very, very important picture together. A lot of hard work from both managers and parents and players to come all the way to Jamaica to participate in this tour. Of course, we're going to start today's proceeding with the national anthem of both teams. So at this moment, we invite our fans to stand in respect of the national anthems for both Canada and Jamaica. We will be starting with the anthem for Canada.
Hi, guys.
Thank you.
now be played. Give you the lineup for both teams. Just to introduce the coaching staff of the Jamaica national team. Mr. Shane Brown is the head coach, assisted by Mr. Steve Scott. Shane Brown is the head coach at Spanish Town High School. Four times under 19 champions in the local high school competition. Steve Scott, under 16 champion for several years. Very good program at St. Catherine High School as well. The team manager is Mr. Deron Davis, head coach at the Arcabessa High School. The referee in charge is Mr. Kemoy White. He'll be assisted on the lines by Mr. Andrew Dixon and also Mr. Adrian Hall. Rugby is Chris, the manager for the Canada team. Chris, can you just introduce the coaching staff? Good afternoon. As you see Jamaica here with the ball deep in Canada's half. penalty awarded to Jamaica. Too long in the tackle there, not releasing when the referee called the held, I believe was the call. Chris, tell us a little about some of your players. Who are some of the guys that we need to, well, I mean, we have to look over all of them, but tell us a little bit about some of your players.
Canada's players are from both the west and east of Canada, British Columbia, or BC, and Ontario. One of the biggest players is Hunter Grant, prop wearing 10, weighing 240 pounds, 6'5". Our two captains today are Thomas Blackburn and Quinn Nawati. Thomas comes from the mainland of BC, and Quinn coming from Vancouver Island.
Enjoying yourself as we see Daniel Bailey here, so glad this man going for the strong carry. So even a contested game so far, both teams feeling each other out as we see Mikel Pace there punting that ball up here. Adrian Parks here from our Marcus and I with the chase. Team Canada recovers. Love is scooting around the rock area there. Five. So we're coming here and doing some good work. First, this is Canada players, very capable players. Obviously, they are very skillful and powerful ball carriers. And very good passes of the ball as well, Chris. It must be a real proud moment for you. You guys to see this game.
The draft point to the sub round, please. Yes, contact lens number 7, Connor Byrne.
So we see Team Canada there coming up with a knock-on from the kick by Anthony Finley on the top of five, I believe it was. First of all, say big up to all our fans and stands today. We see supporters coming out in their numbers. We're very happy that we've come out to support Team Jamaica once more. Big up the Bozeman them, I see them making the noise on the right side. Of course, we see the Spanish on Vikings in the house. Make some noise, Vikings. Of course, the Jamaica Defense Force Warriors in the house as well. A few army men supporting these youngsters. DC Foster Lions also in the house showing their support. Big on the Dragons as well. Big up to all the Dragons men who are here supporting the young Jamaicans today. You see Canada tapping out on the left side. Love the ball movement over here. Lovely ball work down that left edge until finally finding that gap just up the middle of the field.
Good job, Max!
So, you know, all your boys performing so far, they seem to be hanging in very well in there.
One thing that's been a challenge for us in Jamaica is to put not just the community, we're just not used to this. Some of the boys from Ontario. But most of the ones from the west of Canada, it's kind of a drier heat. Me, myself, originate in the UK, from Scotland and Wales, that's where I was brought up. And this temperature is really alien to me.
Ah, come on, Chris, it's a cool day out here today, man. Look at everyone in their sleeveless shirts and their shorts and everything, man. Red striping on and everything. It's a cool day, Chris. You know, I'd rather be here right now than anywhere in BC or Toronto. Those chili wings are not for us Jamaicans, you know. But, you know, it's a really good game so far, Chris. I mean, it's evenly contested. I think there's about 10 minutes in this game or so, and it's been a real arm wrestle. I think Team Canada definitely showing more structure, you know, more organization around the ball. Jamaican lads a bit growing on their own, you know, not having much shape out there. But really and truly a real close contest so far. Only 4 points in it. So it's going to be interesting to see how the rest of this half pans out.
Come on, guys, let's take our
I would agree. With both sides of some physical runners. Jamaica been coming through one on one. I think the tackle on both sides has been pretty good up to date. And without doubt, it's normal for rugby league. We must have sides that are strong in defense. Canada will certainly challenge the Jamaican defense. They have a goal, they've got a place, they're well drilled. But they need to keep it together to play in a whole lot of places. Strong Jamaican team.
Don't stop,
rugby union for some years. Do you have good rugby skills, good ball handling skills? But this is only the second ever game of rugby union. So the new team is strong.
Of course, Chris, as we enter the water break here at the 20-minute mark, it's going to be 1 minute for both teams. Of course, considering that the Canadians are not used to the 2 minute, referee is playing 2 1-minute break in both halves. It's an interesting two teams today. I think the Canadians definitely, for the moment, using that size of the central to win this game today for you guys.
Oh, without doubt. But as usual, you look and you see the big boys. You see that they are on the field. But that's the real speedsters in there too. The fullback, he's on the counter, with a lot of speed. If you look at the two wingers as well, yes, they're tall, but the slim. It's just the fitness and stamina, as well as that acceleration that makes them stand out to them. Zakim and Donovan. You know, don't be fooled by one winger's beard. He is an under 17.
If that case, you know, when I'm in the Canada team of the airport, you know, I thought it was a senior team embarking from the bus. You know, quite a few of the lads, of course, you know, they have parents and stuff like that. But of course, as I've explained to a lot of our lads, you know, there's a big diet difference between, you know, what the Canadians are having in Canada versus our own diet. So, you know, we are not being as heavy as the kind of lads. Check out how heavy we see coming up with the arrow at the restart. Canada, of course, just about 20 meters in Jamaica's half. They have good position. Really and truly, it's a lovely attacking platform for them. You know, Jamaica really can't afford to meet those type of errors on the first tackle if they don't want to stay in this game.
Get what you're saying, Ramon. One thing's for sure, Canada is just not to Jamaica. They're taking the names of Ramsey, his scorches, and his boys. Certain workers. So Jamaica dominated things for the first 10 minutes. They were camped out in Canada's half, but they were unable really to shoot that ball from left to right or right to left. You know, too many one-up hits around the ruck. You know, too many individual actions. And of course, we see Canada now gaining the ascendance in the last 10 minutes, scoring 12 points, I believe, to move on top in this game. So I think Team Jamaica really needs to. Alright, 10-0 in favor of Canada.
And I think the Jamaican lads will need to lift their heads and start playing more as a team, start moving that ball around and use that speed that they have. Open their eyes on defense as well. You know, I think that some of the lads are a bit switched off at the moment. As you see Mikel going for the short kick. He recovers, steps one. He needs to tackle himself. Mikel faces there with a lovely cheeky play from the kickoff. That's Adrian Parks we see attacking on the right side. Let's see what the Jamaicans will do. Can they move this ball to the hands? Referee there awarding a penalty to Team Jamaica. And it's Casado there who we see running headstrong into about five penalty defenders. Again, I say that the Jamaicans really need to move this ball along versus try to play this physical game against Canada, because Canada's guys basically are they're very sizable players. You know. Again, we see Jamaica trying to penetrate five players instead of moving the ball. Really need some shape and some precise passing to stay in this game. Passes, lads, passes, that's what is needed. Canada's defense team very rugged right now, Chris. Staying on top.
Jamaica is certainly making Canada. Making Canada keep their eyes open. A quick restart. Let's get them on the line. But solid defense so far is keeping Jamaica out. Particularly with good tackles by Quinn, captain, leading by example at number 30. And Zach Bain, the fullback, come here. This is the second scorer for Canada, driving through there, Evan Bryant, to Tommy Blackburn and Trevor Purcell. Trevor Purcell in the scrum cap is a 15-year-old. Again, only his second game of rugby league ever. Ronan Clark driving through, penetrating. Good 15-yard second. Tony Blackman, records from half.
Last was Scotland, at the 19 level.
So it's good to see that we have come down at 8 goals, and hopefully in years to come, we might be able to take it up to that 15. Right? This is just the start. So rugby is new in Canada. They're trying to grow it. In some ways, they're trying to grow rugby here in Jamaica. So that kick went a bit too deep. We are giving Canada a free 20 meter. Connor taps off. Well, that's right there, big lad, good offload. Good offload again. Referee starts an improvement. Send ball it forward. As you see, okay, so the Jamaican crowd getting into it now. No? Those of you who play the sport or aspiring to play the sport, what that young winger did was actually what you're supposed to do. Realize he was not distracted by any of the defenders at all. He only had eyes for the try line. He didn't look to the right, he didn't look to the left, he did not look behind him. He got the ball and there was one thing in his mind. Get to the try line. Very well done. Better than some of the senior players, right? Better than Double D? Yeah.
Well done, winger, well done.
Better than Kenneth?
Yeah. Yes.
Sorry, they said they don't have, you don't have any speed, so you shouldn't be talking on.
Oh,
The grunt, definitely holding on. Make against the game. And then take there. Put the foot back, the other three. That game is on the counter. Give him a minute, and he'll be away. Quickly taken, Danabaska moving on.
By Canada before they lost the ball. If you realize, you know, they were basically wrapping from the middle of the field, hitting 1, 2, 3, moving to the right. You know, just unfortunate that he lost the ball. But so far, as I said before, the tackling by both teams in this game for this level has been outstanding, and I hope that they can continue for the full meeting. Set by Jamaica. They have a long line out to the left, but they chose to go right. The line out is still there. And that was statistic. Let's see what Canada will do on this exit set. Exit set, as it is called, they are exiting their own end of the field. So here, teams on the move try to be safe. In terms of either they play one up like this, one single pass, or they speed from the rugby area. So let's see the type of set that they will do. Okay, so that's the second one up. It's half time by the ref. Come on, Carl, let's get into it. Give these boys, both teams, a big round of applause.
Wonderful bus drivers, I'll tell you. The commentary of things across where we've been on trips and things like that really came through on one of the bus trips when the boys asked the driver to turn off the Jamaican music, which the boys have been listening to since they came here because they love it. But they wanted to listen to the driver talking. They wanted to know more about Jamaica, more about its history, more about the Jamaican experience. And I'll tell you right now that our boys going back to Canada will never ever experience a tour like this one ever again in their lives. So thank you very much to all of you Jamaicans for what you have done. Jamaican supporter here wants us back next year. We'd like to see Jamaica and Canada as well. We really will. Return the favor that you've given us and look after you. If you ever get the chance to come over, that's what this is about. Building the world in rugby league. I think we have played you at one level or another every single year, feeling not, for the past 6 or 7 years. And I think, you know, that goes a far away seeing how much you guys are coming to the game. Selecta, what's your music now?
They have a lot of running games. They need to get the passing game on. As you can see, the one time they did get the passing on, they capitalized on that and they scored. So they need to use their hands a little bit more, trust themselves. When in good
All right, so that's the English version of what Nasha just said. One of the real elders of the game. Good game so far, very good game. The youngsters have been playing extremely well. I think in terms of tackling, they have been doing very, very good in terms of the tackling. There's no one-up tackling. They have been tackling in terms of group, almost like a beehive. So I just want us to see doing what they have been doing. I haven't even more dimension to the passing game. They be quite fine. Well said. And from the national captain, Sir Spuddy, quick word before the second half.
Can you hear me?
Advice.
Well, big up everybody. I don't know Michael representative. All right, may I say? All one thing the rules them do, I just get back and set up. You see me, them a play too flat. So we just want them hold the set, the composure, you know, some up, some back, and deal with it. Like what I'm going to play so far.
Oh boy! Oh,
Very poor penalty there after five tackles. Canada on the charge again. Let's see what they bring in attack and what Jamaica brings in defense. Referee, that signal is actually ripping. As a defender, you're only allowed to win the ball if it's a one-on-one tackle. As long as there's more than one defender, you're not allowed to win the ball. Let's hear from our very new chairman of the Jamaica Rugby Football Union.
Yeah, the more prolific sport of rugby, Jamaica Rugby Football Union. That's right, Roy. Of course, you distracted everybody. He's trying to make me look bad. So he's gonna say that as soon as I get the microphone, Canada scores again. I just got here and I missed all of the first half of the game. Based on what I've heard and what I've seen so far, I think we're not exploiting our runners in our line. We have five, or I think about four experienced international players on this team playing for Jamaica. These boys represented last summer, beginning of the summer in Miami. We need to utilize their prowess a little bit more. Get more of this back line working to see if we can run on these big fellows.
Was that pull out Friday?
No man, today I sat there. Rugby looks good out here today, I must tell you. It's a brilliant thing when rugby league started bringing rugby to Barbican, and so we can get a chance for everybody to come and sit and watch and be exposed. Yeah. You know what's beautiful about this? From ever since we have been playing rugby, our greatest challenge is whenever we play international, other teams from other countries, is that the size of the players we play against have always been twice our size. And we're yet to match them for size. So what we don't have in size, we have to make up for in heart. Yes? So we have to play a little harder, try a few more things, and make less mistakes.
Be fearful, except from week after week. We're about 40 years ago, I mean.
Nobody can tell from looking at your door, Rob.
Hard life.
Clark riding in.
Jamaica defending well. Jamaica pressurizing on the line. Tony back from the corner, Byron. A good solid tackle by Jamaica. Ball to Roland Clark on the line. Referee there to study it closely. Good position by the ref. Jamaica on their own line. Jamaica discussing what the plan is. Tommy Black running on the tackle. Under pressure, it happens in any game. See the seniors and internationals do the same thing. Nothing worse than being under pressure on the line, but Jamaica still helps Canada out despite the knock on. For some reason, get the mic taken off me again.
So, Jamaica has just defended their line for six tackles. Got the ball, turn it over. Tackle two, and now you'll have to defend your line again for six more tackles. I'm telling you, this is very, very tiresome.
Oh yeah, when you're on your heels in rugby, you feel like the whole weight of the world is on your shoulders. Trust me, your legs get tired, your arms are tired, your mind is tired. This is when you know where you have really good players, the ones who keep playing right through, no matter what.
That's right, play on both sides of the ball, attack and defense. And you can really, really tell the good players. You know, you will see them run very hard when they have the ball, and they run just as hard when they do not have the ball.
That's because they've got the disease. The disease is called rugby. It gets under your skin. The disease goes to your heart, and then you're possessed by rugby, and it's totally incurable.
I endorse that statement 100%. Once you're infected with rugby, it's for life. Oh, good hit. Yeah, very good tackle. Tacky on the wing, good run, straightening up nicely. Here we go, Canada on the attack again.
Tommy Blackburn taking the restart from Ronan Clark. Just held it off his Friday night. For the rest decision. Luce Carly there by the hooker. Game of Lambs under pressure, very close to the try line. Referee and Linesburg conferring. Run to Jamaica. Canada shouting, win it back. A lot of communication now. A lot of talking amongst both teams. This is not a game of just crashing in. They've got to have good communication skills as well as the physique and the ball handling and the tackling to go with it. Canada driving to make a attack back. Good leg work by Jamaica. Gonna sidestepping, challenging the Canadians. Again, long leg strides, causing Canada to really need to tackle. Jamaican kick. Offside. Rugby League says Rugby Union, the ball is kicked by your own player. You cannot run to take that ball. The kicker or another member of the team behind you must put you onside. You're in front of the ball kicker, you're offside. So Canada take the restart. Rolling flag coming off on this side with the trainer.
Okay, so once again, defending our own line. This is about the third set in a row. Let's see what the Canadians can come up with. Let's see if the Jamaicans can match them. Good, strong, driving tackle. Has a big overlap to the right. Will they use it? No, he decided to go on his own. Good read, good defense. This is the last tackle. What can they come up with? Alright, so that's good work by the Jamaicans. Come on, let's get it up. I think the Jamaican coaching staff needs to copy what the Canadians are doing. The Canadian coach has been on the field and he's getting his boys in the right spots. So I think Jamaica probably needs to do the same thing. You know, our boys need all the help that they can get, right? Mr. Monteith, we're asking you to do what you always do. So once again, the Jamaicans are defending your own line. I think this is the fourth set in about 10 minutes. Did not number up in defense on the scrum. Very, very poor error. That's how you score. Yeah. Coaching staff. The boys need some assistance on the field. Very tight angle for the conversion attempt. Let's see, the breeze is blowing northeasterly. He needs to go for the far post. You went near, that's the result. Somebody in the stands asking is who was the ref in. Inside jab and drop and an end drop. Then say we the other. Play hide and seek.
I play hide and seek, but not passing. I'm carrying 250 pounds, but I'm only 5'2". So that was Ronan Clark coming off. Big turn his foot.
Nice. Nice.
And the scorer for Canada was Zach Keane. Let's bring in the score. So we
Yeah.
10 points to 4. Good drive by Hamish Dream. And his father keeps driving him on the game with his greatest supporters. His father. And the pain ball takes a break. Brings to the shoulder and drives forward. Good tackling by Jamaica. Good solid drive by 15-year-old. They can put in on the scrum. Their own half. Tell me to bring this ball out of them. And again, Evan Bryant driving forward, taking advantage from the knock on, pushing the team forward again. Kind of pretty relaxed in this game.
That's what they mean.
That's the 15-year-old Eli. Eli Mayers. Right on the line. Perhaps he would have been better putting it outside. Bring your three players out there.
So Jamaica has not seen this side of the field for the past 10 to 12 minutes. Okay, so that's water break, quarter time. Good work by trainer Romain Gollichamber. Did very well to keep the Canadians out for that attacking rain. This is a good time to show that secret weapon. Come on, Jamaica, we have defended our line for the last 12 to 15 minutes. It's time for us to chip the ball wide. Let's test these Canadians wide. We have been testing them for the middle of our game. Let's chance our arm wide. Let's see what they have. Trainer Golly Campbell, ensure they follow the instructions. We need quick play of the balls here to do the exit set. The play of the ball is supposed to be very quick. Poor pass there. The runner has to check, make sure that he's got it safely.
You can't attack him to win him, then the man's not ready.
Come on, he's going to kick deep. He's going to chase big. Let's get a big chase on. Referee, a judge, knock on. So Jamaica has finally, after about 20 minutes, seen what this side of the field looks like. Let's see if we can take advantage of it. Trina is very animated. Good sense prevailed. Well done, referee. Try right. Which is why good kickers
try not to kick the ball to an opponent's try here. You're going to kick high, you want the ball to drop just before the try here. Or kick the ball up on the ground. That's a good one there by Baker. Oh, sorry, it's not Baker. He lost the ball. Comes back, Baker, right? I want to give our referee, Kemo and Wipe, a big rap. This is our youngest referee, both in terms of age and in terms of number of games. But I think this year he has really been our number one international referee. And I think he goes a far way to say that he might be number one in the country. Better than? Again, the game has descended into a battle of contact. More ground than brains. Everybody is taking the ball into contact, including the halves. Which means, I think we have seen more knock-ons this half than the first half because the players are getting very tired. Now it's ready to use the players around you. Tackle five, that's about the third tackle five penalty that Jamaica has given away this half. If we can hold the Canadians, let's see where they go with. That's a free ball, this pass. You make a difference in the numbers. Oh, that's a silly penalty right here. They were doing so well. Even the crowd appreciate that. A silly penalty right there.
Chagan, Nakan, as usual. Said no try. Whether we agree or not, referee's decision is final. Sometimes we agree with the referees, sometimes we disagree. But at the end of the day, this is a sport where we respect these decisions. Discussion. Generally, always, the discussion generally takes place when you are in possession of the ball. It's very strange to see the referee allow Canada to discuss the call while it was Jamaica's ball. For the final minutes of this game, the crowd is willing the Jamaican team to do something exciting. Thank you. Keep the rock clean, keep the rock clean. Ooh, but he did not gain 1 meter on that play. Oh, he gained one. Okay. That's 6.5 meters gain. That's 10, a run like that, he need to play the ball. Again. That's soft. Soft, soft, soft. That's what happens when you consistently pressure the defensive line. Good work by Canada. They kept coming and coming and coming. And even though the Jamaica defense tried to stand up to them, eventually you will get tired and you will break down. Well done, Canada. Referee, if I might steal a term from another sport, but like. Mr. Referee, can you get a signal as to how many minutes? That seems like 4 from here. Very good return, very good contact. Yes, the Jamaican players are very tired. Canada is moving forward, finding the pressure on, quick play the balls, hard running straight down the middle. Good skills, good offload, and now they come wide. The linesman saw something. I think he's based on the signal. You see the Canadian player lost the ball at the PTB. Scrum down to make a ball. Canada willing themselves on. They're both pro players who want to keep Jamaica at 0 for the second half. Both teams would love to end the game on a high. Loose carry by Jamaica, recovered by Canada, and once again the Jamaicans are found defending their own goal line. With about a minute to go, which means Canada can close out the game right here. But they decided to go to the sidelines and give Jamaica one last chance to break their line. How kind of you. That's a cardinal sin right there. What up? Back in the rock era. I think both teams deserve a big round of applause. Well done, Canada. Good effort, Jamaica. I think this is a wonderful beginning to hopefully a long-lasting playing relationship between both countries. Thank you, Canada, for coming on over. Well tried, Jamaica. Keep your heads up. This was your first game at this level. And hopefully, time to come, we probably see about the same Canadian players at the under 19 and hopefully the senior level. Line, can you thank you to the fans?
Yeah, man, please pass for me. Good deal, man. Good deal. Good deal. What you want to do? You want to talk to me that way? Hey, man.
Mikel Fies,
right? All right, so the Jamaican captain is with me, Mikel Fies. Very, very good player, very experienced player. What went wrong today and what went good?
I think personally that the reason why we did not score any tries today was that because you need to work the ball more. We're taking more contact. I believe that I was one of the first that taking most contact in the game. So I hope we can train and build back on that, work on the passes and those things. The one thing we had good today was the pass when he took out and passed and scored one try. It was a very good challenge against Canada today. Very good game. Play them again in the future.
Listen, waiting on the Canadian captain.
Sorry, but I wasn't thinking.
Could it be, boys? Could it be?
Oh, yeah, that's got wrecked.
Guys, stay there. I want to get going. Let's get back. Go back a bit.
Thanks for the lighting, sir.
Squeeze in, Simpkin. Squeeze in.
Chino.
Chino.
Squeeze in.
Ted has no idea what's going on. Not like this. Yeah, he has.
Oh, where is he? You already had two?
Hey, boys.
Oh, buddy. I'm feeling tipsy already.
Back up a bit, boys. Back up.
Go back. 3 steps back, everybody.
Fire, bro.
Guys.
Yeah, man, make it tighter, guys.
Yeah,
Smile, guys.
Alright, thank you guys for coming on over. How has the experience been for you lads? You know, both playing and from a cultural perspective.
First of all, I'd just like to thank everyone that came out today and put on this great event for us. It was really good to come out here, come down here. The Jamaicans, very nice people, and it was great being here, great enjoying your culture. Love the food, love the people, love everyone. Game today, thanks to the Jamaican boys for coming out and giving us this game. It was great. Really enjoyed it, and it's probably a great memory that we're going to have for our whole lives. So, thanks.
Thank you for coming.
Alright, our players, I think there's our presentation. We'd love to get some pictures with both teams.
Yeah, we have
guys, you have to sing along.
Yeah, we can.
It's not possible.
Yeah, restart, restart.
Rolling lot.
Come on, rolling.
Come on, rolling.
Yeah, baby.
Thank you very much.
One, two, three, Chino!
Hey, Nick.
All right, that's good.